Hello, Malty Maduro smokers. Ralphie, that's me. Welcome to my whisky reviews. And this is whisky review number 389. And thank you to Ions75 for that introductory malt mention, which brings you into a prolonged series of American bourbon and bourbon-related whisky reviews. With this particular review, we've got an interesting one here, produced by Heaven Hill, although distillery in Bardstown, Kentucky, which is round about there. This is a wheat whisky, so it's not strictly speaking a bourbon, but because it's made of 100% wheat grain, it's most certainly a whisky. This isn't so commonly available outside of the United States. However, if you're looking for a bourbon that has quite a large proportion of wheat, giving it that softer, creamier style, the one you're looking for is Maker's Mark. I've touched on Maker's Mark in previous reviews, but it's probably a bourbon I will be coming back to at some point. Now, the observant amongst you will notice that I haven't actually drunk that much out the bottle. They have tended to be, what I have poured for review has been rather a small portion, because wheat whiskey isn't really my thing. To be honest, I'm really don't connect with wheat whiskey. I find it particularly mild. However, I'm reviewing this because it's part of the diversity of American spirits, which I want you to be aware of. And certainly if you're looking to get your bearings as regards quality bourbons, which traditionally are from a mash bill, they're a combination of spirits, a minimum of 51% corn, but thereafter they can incorporate wheat, malted barley and rye in various proportions. And if you have an opportunity to taste a spirit that's out, you know, a single grain, it gives you a point of reference, it gives you your bearings when you start to kind of observe the activity of that particular grain or style of grain when it's combined with other grains. I hope that made sense. Well, it made sense to me, to be honest. The thing about wheat, the style of wheat, it's soft, it's creamy, it's mild. For quite a number of people, it may come across actually as featureless and flavourless. However, if you're patient, if you persevere, you will start to get the subtleties of it. And this is a really quite a well-made spirit, made at Heaven Hill Distillery, where they tend to know what they're doing. This is quite a kind of refreshing change from the norm. It's been bottled at 45%, and this, I think, is important with wheat whiskies. Because they are mild, because they are gentle, they need that extra strength of alcohol in the bottle to deliver the impact and a little bit extra flavour. And I noticed that when any distillers kind of reduce the strength of their alcohol, there can be an outcry from discerning whiskey fans and assorted whiskey drinkers. I am thinking of a particular brand, Maker's Mark, sure, okay, I'm just mentioning it, who reduced the strength of the alcohol in the bottle recently. And due to the brouhaha, great word that, or the kickoff that ensued afterwards, they put the strength up back up again. And one reason why the strength particularly matters is that when you've got lighter spirits involved, any drop or fall away of the actual strength of alcohol has a major impact on the flavour. alcohol, I think it really needs it. At 40%, this would really be quite anemic. I'm adding a little drop of water, not too much. Nose. Let's start with soft, because it is soft. Biscuity cereal. Breakfast cereal. Mixed grain. Rusks. Cookie dough. Camphor. Soft fresh mint. Mild, very mild cinnamon. There's a creaminess, slight gingery heat, but this is a soft nose. To some it may seem anemic, but it's a gentle, it really is a gentle variation in the theme. Taste wise, very paced, steady arrival. There's no explosion of flavour here. It's just not happening. It's more a sweet, steady, sour grain arrival. Guava, unusual note actually. You wouldn't associate with corn whiskey, but with wheat whiskey, you're getting a guava, tropical fruit. Vanilla, mild honey, floral notes, some perfume, some eau de cologne, rose water, orange oil, and particularly a kind of floral note, jasmine. The finish, sucrose, mild and light. So not really packing a big punch into the finish, far from it. It just ain't that style of liquor. If you're a big flavour fiend, you might be put off this, but if you're an explorer, a spirits adventurer, a wheat spirit is very much one to try, to understand what distilled wheat is. Not as part of a mash bill, but on its own. And this is good quality stuff. Mark. Again, I marked it down because it's such a gentle flavour. 83 out of 100, and that is grain whisky mark. If it was malted barley, and I would give that a whisky mark, but certainly if it was rye, I would give it a grain mark, a similar grain mark. But this is, compared to rye, this is the very antithesis. This is the quiet little thing that sits in the corner, and if you've got someone who's intimidated by flavour, who wants something that's more or less brandy-like, then this would certainly be a good quality option. I'll have one more taste before I sign off. To its credit, as a kind of, I've seen it happen before. I really wasn't kind of clocking it too heavily, but there's a citrus note coming in. But then again, the citrus is not, it's rounded, it's not hugely characterful. Some interesting vanilla-y wood sours, but no, I think I'll stick to 83 out of 100. That's my mark. Any final comments before I go? Not quite my style of grain whiskey, but having said that, it's been well made, and I do want to acknowledge that. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to return again, I'll be moving on to the next bottle on the shelf, Rowan's Creek. And that'll be Whisky Review 390. See you soon.